of tomorrow's invitational bracket. So it's either Andres or Siskui. But yeah, Spain is gonna do some work there. one of those guys will qualify himself already.
Alright, let's see if this is just a button check. Yeah.
Yeah, maybe. Of course. Schmoving around. I mean, you know, on Pokemon Stadium. Just like checking it out. Especially Sesqui, like, I mean, he was playing against Full Bloom. I mean, he should play against Full Bloom, but then again, sat on Full Bloom's side. Something didn't really work out as planned. So he's gonna opt it out. And yeah, taking some damage. I mean, almost got baited there. But yeah, it seems clean. It seems clean.
Yeah, the connection looks pretty nice. I don't see any stuttering at this point, so...
Yeah, not at all.
And from what I can see on Siskui's part, just moving around those platforms, hovering all across the field. Mm. I mean, it looks pretty playable.
Yeah. So, again, I'm just checking out on some stuff, and... Yeah.
All right,
looks good. So, I think we can proceed to play out this winner's finals and add again secure ourselves a really good game. And one of those guys will secure this sweet, sweet spot. And I mean, again, it's only the spot, only the chance to go up against Europe's best and maybe, just maybe, take out that big, big prize pot. 5,000 euros in the pot, man. For an online tournament on top of that, like that's nothing you see from day to day out, but yeah, again, it was normally planned as an offline event with an online invitational, but yeah, we saw how things proceeded and now we have to go for plan B, but I hope it is still somewhat hype. So I love those matches so far, and it's not obviously it's not the same as a normal environment is, but I'm enjoying myself so far, man.
Yeah, I feel so entertained by those players, by the whole by the sets we already witnessed, and dude, it's going to be a show from here on out.
Oh, and it surely will, man.
Especially at this point, man. Winner's final is always a pleasure to see. So I'm definitely hype about what's going to happen next. I think about Ken and Samus, the matchup itself, and I feel like. On paper, Samus definitely has the upper hand against Ken, because she just can float around, keep stage control for days, dish out small hit chunks with her projectiles and stuff, or go for big damage as we see as we just saw Siskui do his follow ups on his charge shot with back airs and stuff.
Yep.
So,
exactly.
But still. As soon as Siskui manages to do some minor mistakes here and there and play into Andre's event cards, then things might turn around pretty fast and it might be Andre's event turns. So let's just wait on the matches to start and then we will see more.
Yeah, and sure, as you mentioned, like Andres Afan obviously being one of the big favorites in this invitation. I mean, not in invitation really, but like in the online qualifier. I mean, he proved countless of times how insane he is. And I mean, looking at his tournament record, man, I only see those single-digit placements in the offline environment. In online, though, still single-digit placements most of the time. This man is just a beast, man. And playing with Ken himself, not only going for those wake-up shoryus, but also for a decent game plan and nice tempo. We're going to see him perform, man. And he's starting out big with those four chunks of percentage. Like 58 already, and this match is only 10 seconds old.
Yeah, these combos, man, you want to take those hits as Ken. Oh, these up beats out of shield, man. You have to be so precise about these because Ken can convert so much of your mistakes. So Siskui definitely has to be super careful. Oh, damn. Ooh. That was the first stock.
Yeah, there's no testing waters no more, man. You gotta watch out for those options. And I think Siskui, yeah, there's some reality check going on. I mean, he's still going for it. Maybe finding out those options. But yeah, Andres knows. He will not really keep pushing those buttons. I mean, he can time those. Ooh, really nice high recovery. You want to watch out this Ken, especially. Ken's recovery options are quite limited, you might say.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, especially against characters like Samus that can control offstage situations with all of her projectiles that good.
Oh, yes.
But still, yep, it's again looking like a nice game for Andre Safin at this point.
Yeah, he wants to like play it not too fast. I mean, Ken likes to play those slow battles. I mean, he just waits until he is in his burst of bubble, but until he gets there, he has to kind of move around those options from Samus, and yeah, that's one way to get back on edge.
Yeah, definitely the hit stun kind of knocked him on the stage. I mean, we'll take that because he was eating so many of these down bees with his Shoryuken.
Yeah, and I think timing's a big factor here. He wants to, that's right, wait until Sesqui is quite frankly in range, until Andros can like pop in and get this big damage done. I mean, already 120%, and oh no, it's not Andros who died, it's his. It's Andros who died. Okay, that was
looking really weird. Yeah. I kind of felt that Sisqui died at this moment, but then again.
thanks Andros for correcting me there. I mean, now Sisqui is the one who is losing the stock, and all of a sudden, being on the last stock in game one, so Andros, he's being a force, and especially on Smashville, it's a stage he really likes to play on, and yeah, I mean, you can see it really.
Definitely, definitely. Yes, still his lead up on his sleeves. 61%, I mean, that's nothing. He has to be super careful right now because Sisqui is going to rely a little bit more on his projectile gameplay, as we might just notice. But still, it's not a bad spot here.
Oh, those Sisqui slowly finding himself at the back footing. He does not have a lot of space to work with, and that's a lot of damage, and it will not take long until he's dead. Andres pushing things up. Sisqui, wonderful answer.
Now he's keeping his momentum with the aerial Hadouken, not going for the Tatsu immediately. Oh, back air is not enough at this point, but still, yeah, that was across the whole side, so.
Fighting it out and
pitch.
It's barely connected. It's a screw attack and immediate answer with those forward airs. And that's what you mentioned, Lemon. I mean, those are really those kills you want to look out for, especially against Ken. Because if you want to contest him on the stage, yeah, you will fight yourself in a blast of real quick, man.
Ooh, this is going to be it. Yeah, definitely. He was standing on the platform, got the whole Shoryuken done, three hits. Man, this move has so much knockback. It's actually crazy.
Yeah, I mean, it sucks to get hit by it, but man, does it look satisfying. I mean, Ken in general, man. Whenever I see this up B, man, I kind of have to cringe inside because I know how it feels when I get hit by it. But man, this move still looks so good, man.
Definitely. Definitely. I kind of like the idea that Ken seems to be on a little bit higher spot on certain tier lists above Ryu because, man, along the Shoryuken is such a nice looking move with all the flames going on. I mean, as soon as Ryu hits his Shoryuken, you get this one big hit that hurts for days, but, you know, you're never complaining about some flames around your hand, so.
I mean, you're literally burning alive, so I don't know about that one, Chief, but on the other hand, though, I really love how you mentioned Ken and Ryu's dynamic, because those are two characters who are still really developing in the meta, not only because we do not have a lot of Shotos, not only in Europe, but internationally, but the players that we have, they're constantly pushing the characters to new limits, and I really like how Ken and Ryu found themselves in the meta game. I mean, sometimes you want to rather opt for Ryu, and I think Andres know that. I mean, Andres still has a lot of Ryu games up his sleeve, but Ken obviously being his main pick. And against Samus, it seems like that's the more valid answer, because so far, he's rocking the stage, man.
Oh yeah, definitely. Game 2 with nice Gormit race. This time, I love this idea of the patches that we can play some different tunes on the stage. Gets another feeling for those sets.
Of course.
All right. And so far, yeah, Andre Safin getting a nice start again in this game. I think those three platforms might help him as well.
Constantly pushing things up, and again, he's just waiting for Sisqui to kind of get an approach done, and yeah, just baiting out those screw attacks. I mean, Sisqui, he knows that it didn't work. I mean, he's just going again. Like, he's just enabling himself to go for those constant up B's out of shields. He expects Andres to push forward to press some buttons, but Andres instead, he knows when to press those buttons, and that was one of those timings.
Yeah, double short kick into hard Shoryuken, man. You love to see it. Those are those confirms. You have to input rather quickly, but as soon as you land them, they are so satisfying.
really big hits in the screen. You want to push it forward, maybe. Ken managing himself to
almost. Something bad happened there.
Yeah, and that's really hard, like against those little bombs of Simon's legs. He managed to find himself back on Smashville, but sometimes, the gimmicks kind of get the better of him. And this time, Siskui is pushing up, sadly missing the screw attack. And Andrew is right now finding himself in the neutral state, pushing up. Samus finding herself at the ledge. And this is really not where she wants to be in the long run. Andrew's already pushing things up, man. He's on fire right now.
One grounded Tatsu and we have 33% more on the clock. It's actually ridiculous. Ooh, mid-air. Yeah, that could have hurt big time. Oh, but nice catch here from Siskui. Oh, playing so well right now.
Oh, he's nice. Oh, he cannot find himself back. Oh, unfortunate though. At this time, Andrus finding himself in the last stock, but I do not think he minds too much because for now, he is really in control of the tempo of this game. And Siskui, he kind of has to adapt for it. And so far, he does a really good job doing so though, finding damage himself.
Of course, definitely. And
going really deep.
Oh, dude. I mean, Ken go for these options, dude. This sentence sounded so weird. Anyways, he can go for this kind of situation because his Shoryuken actually travels pretty high in comparison to Ryu's Shoryuken.
Yeah, even if it's by a bit, it's quite a lot of range. Oh, wonderful conversion there, kind of baiting Andrus into the bombs and that was a really quick up B. So Siskui, nice. You like to use those up B's? Well, I do too, so let's try to find things out, shall we? And Andrus being the one who kind of has to slow down his play a bit. Siskui right now finding himself in the spot where he blows out the game in a wonderful fashion, putting out those legs and getting the JB2 on top of that.
Definitely covered the neutral getup so well with his down B and just waited for the smart bomb to explode so he can follow up easily with his up tilt. Paid off just as fine. And he took this game. Good stuff from Siskui.
Yeah. And it kind of came to surprise because Siskui kind of accepted Andrus to put up the tempo in this game. Like he was just letting him do his stuff and just waiting until he can get this one conversion. And it's kind of similar to Snowmander because Siskui, he does not really want to pressure up too much. I mean, he likes to have some tempo up on his own. We saw it in the last stock especially, but he kind of takes his time and with success on top of that. So right now, Andrus has to find something out, wait for his opportunities himself, or maybe we'll just keep being the aggressor he is.
Yeah, and this stage selection sequence was super fast, man. We are back into the next game. Those guys aren't losing any time. I mean, we are a little bit behind schedule, so...
Hopping right
thanks
into the
for that, homies.
Yeah, Andrus knows, man. I'm a fast-paced player. I got you guys, okay? Let me get this real quick, but Siskui has none of that. So, obviously, wonderful ant here into an up B conversion. This is 58% on Andrus' deck, so... Yeah, you might watch out for those combos. Siskui has some on himself as well.
Yeah, these are those kind of bread and butter combos that Samus can pull out easily on low percent. Up air into up B is such a nice sequence she has on her toolkit, so...
Oh, what wonderful chases so far, and this might be a spot where Andrus himself wants to find himself into, but Siskui kind of makes it hard for himself. Like, he wants to land, of course, but Andrus, he's getting closer and closer. 117 already, but that means more rage points for Ken.
Oh, and Siskui still loves to go for these up B's out of shield. I mean, it's such a great tool and it paid off so many times. But still, you have to be super careful. I mean, Ken on rage right now. Dude, those punish situations can hurt pretty badly.
Yep. Yeah, so we cover again, and up throw will not be enough. Okay, he was barely below 150, so Ken being a mid-weight, it was close and really good the Iron Ken's part, but yeah, this one will also not be enough. Okay, never mind, I will just stop talking already. Okay, thank
nice
you.
Catch,
finally
nice catch.
Kind of a wonderful catch, and man, this one you can obviously not deny at all. Siskui right now being the aggressor, at least in the bad state, and right now he's pushing up again, and this is a whole different game, Lemon. This looks like it's Siskui's turn to play, man.
Oh, yeah, definitely. I was ready to say don't be so fast with these kind of sentences, but damn, he survived that Shoryuken pretty good, nicely. Staying at his. Okay, now that's it. 39%, not the biggest of leads you can have. Yeah, but we definitely saw. Oh, a nice shield break.
Ooh, that happened, so Siskri, what will you do out of it? Oh, really? Oh my, okay, he wanted to go for the reset, okay.
Ah, so, damn, I like the idea, the idea.
Every set of ready taking out the stock, but I appreciate it still. 80%, 79 to be more precise, on Andre's hands. Oh my god, not barely not connecting that down air. Okay, yeah, you gotta watch out for Andres because he's constantly a threat. Siskri, he wants to play it a bit more faster than those other games. He wants to assert the dominance just like he did with Normanda. He wants that final spot. That spot into that invitation.
Ooh. Keeping him on the ledge, yeah, definitely helping him out. Oh, this second hit of the Nair, you have to be ready for it if you start parrying this move.
Yeah, I really love this plan as well. Like, he's just landing with the snare just inside Ken, literally. He knows Ken can only parry one hit. And this was a really good answer to this down B of Ken's. One of the multi-hits that Samus has in this matchup, which are very beneficial and really important. Kind of find an answer for those approaches.
Yeah, it's definitely helping out in the matchup if you have multi-hits like these. And Samus with her up B being a good killing move as well on high percentage. So that's nice to have. Actually takes off one of Ken's approach and save options for maneuvering across the stage.
Siskri finding himself again in a very comfortable spot, knocking Ken off stage, and this might be... No, it didn't really connect! And Anders reacted to it and answered with the back of himself. But Siskri right now, pushing it up yet again, shaking it off, and go again. He does not want to throw this game away. This game, which was so dominant for Siskri up until this point. I mean, it still really is, but Andres, being the threat he is, yeah, pushing up whenever he can.
He blocked the pickup hitbox from the up B with his focus attack, so got away safely. Nice option for this sequence. Oh, damn!
There we go. Oof, okay, Siskri. I mean, unlike game one, he's turning up right now. He wants the spot. I mean, having a really good bracket run as well. He does not want to fall in losers for now. He wants to get this winner side top 16 spot. And so far, it looks good. In fact, he's at match point. So Andres, favorite, he has to win two games in a row to cancel out this momentum against the Samus, man. As Ken, I can see it being a really hard... A really hard mission, man. Really tough on top of it, man.
I mean, we just talked about before the set that the matchup itself is pretty tough for Ken. Mm-hmm. And so right now we see the adjustments on Siskri's playstyle and it's paying off. So that's the best spot you might actually have for this set. Do match point to get into qualifiers.
Yep, and
for
we go
tomorrow
again.
Is so great.
Ooh. Okay, man, and we are heading right back into Pokemon Stadium 2. I mean, it wasn't looking too bad for Andres, so I can see why he would pick the stage again. But Siskri, if he keeps up this momentum, this might be the game he is looking for.
Okay. Yeah, nice BNBs. Oh, fell off. Fell out of the up B at the end.
I really like how Siskri just wants to approach with this neutral air of his because he knows Andres likes to go for those parries just so he can get his punish game set up. But it's really easier said than done. He cannot parry twice. I mean, he can try to go for it, but so hard against Samus. Not quite now,
damn,
Andres.
He landed six up airs already.
Yeah.
Damn, 99%. Just think about how much percentage those up airs just took, man. Yeah, Rage, Shoryuken at this percentage. That's definitely the kill.
Still at level one.
Two hits, 35%. That was a down smash cancel into the command kick.
Yeah,
command roundhouse.
Yeah. This is the threat that is Andres. So, Siskri, you want to calm down a bit. Maybe not too much momentum.
Goodness.
Wonderful break. And he might want to push it again because Siskri, he's playing a bit more on the slower side of pace. So, yeah.
Oh,
wonderful.
Yeah, nice option here to go for the back air. Andre's Avenger just wanted to pop out his focus attack, but wasn't quite fast enough for it, so got hit by it, and this is a nice stock for Siskui's part.
Yeah, I mean, especially like Siskui, he needs to kind of slow down the momentum that Andres has, and so far he's doing a really good job just keeping him at the end of the stage. He does not want to board it out for far too long, but now Siskui finding himself in a rather disadvantageous spot. Andres, he might push it out yet again.
Oh, the parry into... Yep. Oh, that was so cool. Nice.
He's waiting
parry
for those. Yeah, he's waiting.
Down to Shoryuken. That's right. I mean, he's making the most out of the parry situations, and that was some flashy style to finish off stock.
Yep, of course. And again, going for parry after parry, Andres. Yeah, he's not really finding himself in the loser spot so far. He still has two games, but yeah, one of those games are... They might be this one as well. Like, he needs this match point. He needs to proceed in winners. He does not want to go for the loser's one at all. Andres right now, again, being in the momentum, just like in game one.
Oh,
he's
my...
Going for
it. Oh, no, that kind of backfired, but I... Oh, damn, that would be so cool. But nice awareness here from Siskui and kind of sneaked out the kill for himself. That's a good play.
I mean, losing myself in words, sometimes Andres is playing it a bit too fast, maybe. Siskui, he kind of watched for those opportunities. But now, great punish. Oh, yeah, and that's a problem that Samus has. Samus kind of struggles to find back on the map as soon as she's on the ledge. Now pushing it up. I mean, obviously waiting for this conversion. She kind of goes for this Normander style, waiting for those conversion hits, but it's easier said than done. Opting for the dash attack, being a bit more aggressive, so Siskui maybe got something in the hang of it.
This might be a big chance right now for Siskui. He took stage control right now. He's in back in the neutral. Ken was so having so much fun near the ledge where he just could deal out some little hits here and there to build up percentage. Oh, but a random Shoryuken. Yeah, he's just going for it.
Oh man, this might be the wrong suit after all, so Andres was evening it out. Game 5, and I mean, between those two combatants, I wouldn't have any other way, so... I'm kind of looking forward to this Game 5 set, because that means that Siskui's momentum has been stopped, and yeah, how will he respond? Because Andres right now finding himself in the momentum side of things, though Siskui having a counterpick advantage. I don't know if we are gonna see Pokemon Stadium again, or if we are opting for something like Carlos, or maybe even Triplets again.
Yeah, bigger stages might come in handy right now, but I think about... Yeah, I think those big stages with high ceilings might save... Maybe we are going to see Carlos. I kinda see that stage coming up next, because it might help Siskui in that matchup, definitely.
Yeah, I mean, he's kind of feeling himself on this stage as well, so I can see it as well. Though, I mean, again, we have some Triplets as well. So we're gonna see it in a moment. And it's gonna be... Kind of loading it up a bit. Okay, it's gonna be Carlos after all, alright. So, yeah, really big comfort pick for Siskui. A bit on the bigger side of things. So Siskui likes himself some big stages. But Andres, on the other hand, having some more opportunities to fight in the disadvantageous spot. And again, going for those high recoveries, which he normally couldn't do before.
And I like the fact how each player just punishes the other one for overshooting while taking advantage situations a little bit too far. And right now, Siskui getting nice sequences here and there to dish out more percent. Ooh, almost got him.
Yep, almost going for the snipe, and yep, that's what Siskui likes to do. Oh, and they really do not like to fight on the mid stage, so they want to opt out for those advantage positions, and Siskui really does that. He wants to go for this early kill, he wants to stay at those 37%, because if he doesn't, that means Andres has all the more options to find a comeback in this situation. Siskui so far being the one in control right here.
Oh yeah, nice dash attack to finish off the first stock, man. 37%, this stage pick actually kinda worked out already. He didn't have a jump. No chance of getting back, alright.
Yep, punched all the way down, straight into hell, man. All of a sudden, yes. We gotta even game.
He had such a nice sequence, then I opened up my mouth and the stock was gone, so... Damn. Oh, Andre's event is... could be exploding from time to time. And these are those kind of plates that he needs to definitely win against Siskrien on this stage, because right now, still, even though he lost just now his stock, he does such a great job to build out to build up so much damage on Andre's event's account. And damn, like, those charge shots.
It. Yeah, you see it in Siskrien's pace. Like, Kalos establishing itself as a really good pick right now, giving Samus a lot of room to play with. Not only going for those defensive spots, but also in the approaching side of things. Having the platform, having the space. This is what Siskrien really needed. And so far, Andres finding himself again back into disadvantage. And he wants to get out, obviously. But that's easier said than done against Samus' overwhelming force.
Yeah, and I liked the fact that Andre's FN just stayed at the ledge while Siskrien was going for those fake out charge shots. Yeah, and the fair is going to be enough to take the lead, 36%. That's actually just how the first stock ended from Andre's FN. Don't stay too much on the ledge.
I mean, falling off, I mean, that happens. Oh, but I love how Siskrien sets up with those down Bs, because if Andres finds a hit, He has to trade, definitely, because Siskrien, yeah, doesn't want to really get hit by Ken's raw attacks. And we see Siskrien again setting up, having combos himself. Andres has to respect it, but you cannot respect everything at once. This is a whole arsenal that Samus throws at you. And you yourself are just a fighter with some flaming fists.
Oh, okay. He just went for another Shoryuken. I mean, I like the idea, because especially catching aerial opponents while you are standing on the ground makes this move a little bit more powerful.
That's so. A punish. Oh, I think Siskrien can push this. No, going for the safe approach. Yeah, again, going for those down beats. They are working out quite well so far. Also dishing out some good damage, and Andres all of a sudden finding himself 102%.
Oh, okay. Yeah, this scream was this shield was screaming for help. He kind of had to let go, and...
Nice, really good bait. Oh. Yeah, even though Siskrien died here, he didn't really die to this up B, and he expected Andre's up B to someday come out, and this means the download might be complete, because Siskrien is completely under control right now. Right now, not overestimate things. Do not go for those unnecessary risks, and so far, Siskrien's playing it safe.
Damn, that Tava grab is so long. 159%, yeah. Just one good hit might be it. I mean, he's taking opportunity to build up more percentage with those little down beats. 200%, man, this is so dangerous right now.
This might be Siskrien's way into this 5,000 pot tournament. Into this invitation, and this is it. Win,
yeah.
Win.
Oh my.
Good stuff from Siskrien. Damn, he kept the whole stage for himself. That stage pick was so clever.
It turned out so well.
So, nice way to close out this last game for him, to take out Andre's event, putting him into the loser's bracket and kind of snagged him the first place on the qualifying spot for tomorrow.
Yeah, I did not expect it. Like, I expected Andres to just like pop into the tournament and secure himself a big spot. And I mean, he almost did, like going head to head, game 5 against his Spanish companion. But yeah.